Welcome back to On Football. In today's detailed review, we're going to be taking a look at the new Adidas Adizero 7.0 Prime Knit football cleats. This is the Prime Knit version of the Adizero 7.0s. If you're not familiar with the Adizero line from Adidas, it's the lightest cleat in football. They take pride in how light the cleat is, and they've been improving the cleat year after year. So this is the seventh iteration, and it's the first Prime Knit football cleat that Adidas has released in the Adizero line. Now, these were sent over from my partners at eastbay.com, and I'm going to include a link in the description. If you want to buy these cleats, it will show you exactly where you can go to get these cleats in all the different colorways. Like I mentioned in my unboxing, I'm going to compare this cleat to two other cleats in Adidas line. First, I'm going to compare it to the Ultra Boost cleat. Now, this uses a prime knit in the upper, even though it's not a prime knit Adizero cleat. So I'm going to do a little comparison with this and what's different between the Adizero prime knit cleats and the Ultra Boost. And I'm also going to compare it to the normal traditional 7.0 football cleats. This is the Speed of Light version, but all of the tag versions, the camel versions, and then all the Adamoji versions are pretty much the same as this. So you can definitely check out that video for all the ratings and what I said exactly about this cleat. Okay, so let's take a look and revisit the Ultra Boost cleat, which uses a prime knit upper, and tell you how that differs from the Adizero prime knit cleat. Now, this cleat was actually built off the Ultra Boost running shoe. It's more of a casual shoe, which makes this more of a casual cleat. They really stayed true to the outline and all of the performance aspects of the actual Ultra Boost shoe. It uses Ultra Boost in the cushioning, a very, very thin layer, but the Ultra Boost is still there. You can see it through the bottom of the cleat. It uses a plate that's on the new Adidas Freak cleats. You can see that plate here, how that differs from the Adizero line. And the last big difference is the lacing system. It has four different eyelets, which are consistent with the Ultra Boost running shoe, which is very different from the number of eyelets that you actually see on this cleat, and different from the asymmetrical lacing system. So this was, again, built to look just like and perform just like the Ultra Boost shoe, be comfortable in that way. But if you remember that video, this actually has a different type of fit. You don't really get a locked in feel like you do on something like this. You can actually look at the different openings at the top of the cleat and see how those are different. So to summarize, this is gonna be more of a casual cleat. Wouldn't recommend this for games, just like I said in my review. This is gonna be more of a performance cleat. Now, these cleats are gonna have much more in common together than this has in common with the Ultra Boost cleat. The difference between these two is really the prime knit upper. So they both use the same plate at the bottom. They use that Adizero sprint frame plate that you can see here. They both are low cut and they're both really, really light. I'll talk about that when I go into the weight a little bit. Now, they have similar construction in the upper. Both of these try to be one piece. This has an inner booty that's one piece that's actually attached to the outside of the cleat. So when you slip your foot in, this is not a separate tongue. It's kind of one piece throughout the whole cleat. This material is not exactly prime knit. It doesn't have the same stretch properties, but does give you a very locked in feel, a very comfortable fit, and gives you that all that padding on the back of the cleat. Now, the heel counter on this cleat is an external heel counter. As you can see, there's pretty much no internal heel counter. All you have is the additional padding. Now, if you look at this heel counter on the prime knit cleats, it uses the same external heel counter that you're gonna see on the normal 7.0s. They have additional padding on the inside of the cleat that almost acts as an internal heel counter that's gonna give you additional stability because the outside is so thin when you think about the prime knit construction. The upper is totally one piece, everything from the part right around the ankle to the bottom part of the upper into the toe box and the forefoot of the upper is all one piece prime knit construction. The laces go right into the actual upper of the material in a unique asymmetrical lacing system. Now, they do have a TPU layer, I believe, over the end of the toe box. That's gonna add to some stability and also some durability with the actual cleat itself. So those are gonna be the main differences between the Adizero 7.0 and the 7.0 prime knit cleats. So now let's talk about what you're really going to love about these cleats. The first is gonna be the very tight, very snug, secure feeling that you're gonna feel when you put these on your feet. The prime knit upper gives you a very compressive feel. So it still is lightweight, but you just feel really sturdy in these cleats because it is compressive pretty much around your whole foot. Now, because it's prime knit, it's actually going to adapt to your shape. It's totally flexible, but totally compressive at the same time and pretty sturdy and reliable. The second thing that you're gonna love about this is being an Adizero cleat, it's going to keep that lightweight feel of it. Now, when I weighed these compared to the traditional 7.0s, they were only not even a full ounce higher. So these weighed in about 9.7 ounces, and these weighed in just over 10 ounces. That's really not a difference that you're gonna feel on the field. So it's still gonna be lightweight. The prime knit is gonna add to that. Some of you guys out there, when you think about knit material on cleats, you ask about the durability. Now with this, you would think that a knit material is not gonna be that durable, but on the inside, they actually have some overlays that not only add to the stability of the cleat, but are gonna add to that durability as well. Prime knit is something that they use on jerseys. They've been using them on football jerseys for a long time. They hold up, they stretch, but they're also very compressive and they're also super, super durable. So durability is something that you're really gonna love about this cleat. And lastly, one of the things that I was worried about when I unboxed these was, how's it gonna look on foot? I think it kind of has a funny shape outside of the box. You don't really have the same type of silhouette that you do in the traditional 7.0. So like this cleat just looks good standing by itself. You know it's gonna look good on foot. This cleat looks a little funny, you know, before you put on your feet. But if you've seen my Instagram, you saw the post that I made, you've seen these on feet, I'm gonna try to include some footage of that on foot either before or after this video. You're really gonna like how this looks on your foot. It definitely looks totally different. And then when it's under the lights, it actually gives you a different effect. Now the bottom is kind of this like dark chrome material, and under the lights, everything just shines a little bit differently and actually has more of an effect than just this simple kind of black and gray color. So you're gonna love how it looks on your feet, especially under the lights. Next up, I tell you what you're gonna like about this cleat, and that is just what's kind of on par with all the brands out there, what's on par with everything, you know, for a speed cleat on the market. And the first thing you're gonna like is that these fit true to size. So I would expect nothing less. Fits just like an Add-A-Zero 7.0 cleat, so that's true to size. I wear 12, these are 12. But something that you're gonna get additional is you're gonna get that compressive fit. You're also gonna like how comfortable these are. Now, my feet really didn't get hot in these, but you know, in Chicago when I was testing these out, it wasn't that warm to begin with. I would think because of the overlays that they have inside that kind of block the prime knit on the outside, that they wouldn't vent as much, but I'm not sure that's something that you have to worry about. The tongue is fully vented because it doesn't have the overlays on the inside. It's just around the upper that has the overlays on the inside for some of that protection. But I think comfort-wise, you're really gonna like what this cleat has to offer. And last in this part of the video of what you're really gonna like is gonna be the traction on the cleat. Now I go over this every time I talk about Adidas cleats and Under Armour cleats for that matter, but from a traction perspective, these type of studs are not my favorite. I do like studs that have a sharper edge. Adidas used to have the Crazy Quick cleats a couple years ago, back when they had the RG3s, when RG3 was still with the brand, but they've moved to kind of these sprint studs that are a fan favorite. A lot of you guys love them out there. A lot of the NFL players love them. But for me, I definitely like something with a little bit sharper of an edge on the studs. Now, if you look at these studs, they're going to be like all the other Add-A-Zero 7 cleats, but they're going to be rounded up here. They've got these pivotal studs in the middle. And then at the base of the cleat, even though these are rounded, they do have some of the straight edges on the interior parts of the cleat as you dig in. But I've always found that, you know, some of the Nike cleats have a little bit better traction when we talk about the higher end cleats in the Vapor line. So that's why this is something that you're just gonna like about this cleat and not something that you're gonna love is the traction. With every cleat, there are trade-offs, and this cleat is no different. Because you have this very tight, very snug, secured prime knit upper in the cleat, these are gonna be very hard to put on. Now, I made a poll, a little bit of a poll on my Instagram. You may go back to my Instagram. I'm gonna include that link in the description as well. See what people said about that post. But I asked you guys, if a cleat was really hard to put on, but it felt really, really good on your feet, would you wear it? Majority of you guys said like, yes, you would take that putting it on is no problem. But that's how it is. So I'm gonna run a little clip, but you see how hard these are to put on. Even though this part of the cleat actually stretches enough, it is very tough to put on. But once you get your foot inside, you really do have a very snug, secure fit. But that's, again, gonna be a trade-off that you have when you have a prime knit cleat. These are a lot harder to put on than something like the 7.0s that are also a one-piece construction. Another trade-off is going to be the colorways. Now, unlike the Add-A-Zero 7.0s where you've got the Speedalite version, which I showed you in this video, you got the Tag version, which I've done a review on, you've got the Add-Emoji version, which I've also done videos on, these only have three different colors. They've got this black colorway, which again, looks really good under the lights. They've got this gray colorway, which is used in the US Army All-American game. And they have a white colorway, which I don't have with me. But those are the three options that you have. So if you're not wearing white, black, or gray, then you're out of luck. So that's a trade-off with this cleat that they've only got three different colorways. All of them are available at eastbay.com. Definitely, again, that link is in the description. The last trade-off is going to be the price of these cleats. Now, these are what I consider to be very, very pricey for the category that they're in. When you think about the low top speed cleats on the market, you've got Nike cleats at 120, the Nike Vapor Untouchable Pros 3s. You've got the Adidas Adizero 7.0, the regular version, at $120. You've got the Atemoji version at $130, and then you've got these at $150. So you're pretty much paying a $30 premium over the other cleats that are on par with this to have that prime knit. Now, all of you guys are gonna ask me, I already know in the comments, is it worth that price? I just went through the whole video. If you like the things that I said you're really gonna love about this cleat, if that is worth $150 to you, then that price is worth it. If those are not worth $150 to you, then the price is not worth it. Overall, I think it's a solid cleat. If you have the money, you might not be disappointed. You might actually really like these. They do have limited colorways, as I said, so you can weigh the pros, the things that you're gonna like, the things that you're gonna love, and you can weigh the things, you know, the trade-offs, and decide for yourself whether this is worth it. Now, from a player perspective, I think less players actually I would recommend use this cleat versus something like even the regular Adizero 7.0s. So this cleat I recommended for pretty much anyone on the field except for anyone at the line of scrimmage. So basically linemen, I think, can really use this cleat. This one I would recommend only to really speed players. So your corners, your receivers, your speed backs, those would be pretty much the only guys that I would recommend that use this. I think when it comes to someone like a linebacker or a safety, I would just want something that's a little bit higher around the ankle. Not that there's any additional protection. Just the way that it feels around my ankle, it just feels like I have more support. Again, it's not gonna provide any more protection, but you're gonna like how that feels. So that's why I'd recommend this for the fastest players in the game, more the speedier players, your receivers, your speed backs, and your corners. So that's about it. If you like this video, remember to give me a thumbs up, share, subscribe. Let me know if you have these cleats, what you think about them, if you like them, and what color you went with. And I will see you guys next time.